light a candle for the angels, the messenger sent for battle. The holy war exists in more than one way. Wings that are torn, battle no more. Sent out by God, no fear in their heart. Will you listen to them, all demons fear? Light a candle for the angels. The soul's immortality are wings. As some fly blinded and others just die, I choose to keep open my door to the sun, to love I impart. The forgotten angels, I cry, it's all gone too far.
Take me please and fly away. I'm Eva O, and I hope you enjoy this video. I hope it brings us a little closer. This video is all about Demon's Fall for an Angel's Kiss. The Halo Experience is my new project, and my album that's going to be coming out soon is it's about angels and the battle they fight for God. And I don't know what I've gone through in my experiences through the dark side and the light side. I hope you enjoy the album if you've purchased it, and I hope you enjoy this video. We put a lot of work into it for your enjoyment.
Yeah. It's totally different. Live performance is totally different. It's completely different from recordings or rehearsals or playing by myself. And I can think of a few times where that's happened, where I just blocked out everything around me and just played, you know, without thinking. But that doesn't very often happen live. Live is more going off the vibe of the audience, and I know.
Definitely, she's grown in musical styles and her playing style. You know, as most people do after doing music for a long period of time, you start to understand more about it and experiment more with it. With the Superheroines and Speed Queens, I think it was a lot, you know, more aggressive and raw in the way it was presented. And with Halo Experience, I think she's starting to really fine-tune and understand a lot more of what she really wants to be doing with it and becoming a lot more involved in it. Strength and confidence in Eva than I have in a long time, and that's really nice to see. You know, she is a very demanding presence on stage, and I think that suits her better than when we were working with Shadow Project, because, you know, two or three focal points that people would put their attention on either Eva or me or Paris, and I think it's important for Eva to be directly up front, and because her stage presence is so strong, you know, that I think at this point in time it's really important that she present it that way. And we were writing material and figured, well, you know, what's the point in writing the material if we're not going to do something with it? So that's when we decided to form Shadow Project and began working together musically then. Although she had played guitar in Christian Death for a short period of time, and she did backing vocals on our first album. And so off and on we had been doing things together, but that was the first collaborative effort that we had made.
Soul that you might possess. Reality, the soul we all know we possess.
I see children killing themselves. They see a magic in someone else. I won't be there. Leaving you at home, shattered thoughts. Leaving you at home, I see madness on their minds. They see nothing, nothing to find. Thank you.
to life. I call your name. Stand strong. Fill me. For me. You are alone, but free. There are souls that say, souls given away. Discarded shell, break the seal now.
Record and like Christian Death stuff in record stores before. It struck my interest back then and all that. Didn't get to see her, but then got into like say the punk scene, knew what she was about by then.
How many times have you seen her perform live?
Eight times. Oh yes, she has. She was from the three chord punk rock days to now where she's got like arrangements with say keyboards and the violin bow, acoustic stuff and all that. There's been a big, big, big progress per se with her.
Going to impact a lot of people. I know it's impacted me.
It's impacted me. I just had to hear footage from the church, and I was just all covered with goosebumps.
It was such a mystical experience. We had filmed at this church in a cemetery in this LA area, and gosh, just when she turned on the DAF and music, and she was wearing that costume and just singing. She sings from her soul. It's like the muse.
It's almost
takes
like,
over. It's yeah. Haunting. Just beautiful.
And because we're so unaccustomed to that kind of an artistic expression, so unaccustomed to that.
Just a fire, no reason. like when I saw, you know, Shadow Project and stuff like that, I don't know, to me, she gave it that edge that I really appreciated. It's what I, the element that I found in the music that appealed to me was Eva. So. Usher House, that is, played with Shadow Project once, and actually, well, tomorrow night we'll be playing with Eva in Paris at the Roxy with Dave.
To assume or to answer for another artist that I'm working so closely with, but I believe it to be a new revelation, life revelation to Eva. I think that something new is guiding her life now, a very, very positive influence. Whether it's the Catholic God, the Jewish God, the Indian God, I have no idea, but I do know that it's a very, very positive, very loving influence on her life. And I've been happy to be a part of that. You can do music these days without demonic references and make it powerful and make it heavy and even make it dark, drawing from the darkness of what you had felt at one time as to how it relates to your new positive way of thinking.
Eva, when she just started the Superheroines, and I had a band called Community FK, and we've done some shows together in the early days of what was then called the Gloom and Doom movement. It was before the term Gothic was even thought of at that time. It was before the Batcave bands and all that stuff. And when I first started my band, it was kind of crossover Joy Division, punk rock, and she was doing, you know, her version of her passion in that way too. And ever since then, we've become very, very close. And to me, I think she's one of the most underrated songwriters. I think she's one of the most beautiful females playing in, I guess, I don't know what to call it, I guess, rock genre. I don't know what to call, you know. I don't even want to be put in a situation as to have to categorize her music. But
buried soul that you might possess. Reality, the soul we all know we possess. Light a candle for the angels. Fantasy or illusion, it's neither. The closer they fly, the warmer I feel. To open your eyes is all that they wish. They love your well-being. Warriors of strength, you who can hear will know where there's truth. Beware of the fallen, for they wish to be you. You could wind up empty. Death, temptation, a demon's wish. 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 Death, temptation, a demon's wish.
Songs beforehand, or you just kind of learning?
The song that I got to sing on, no, I just heard it for about the previous 4 hours before Johnny said, hey, backups, in there now, because I wasn't expecting that at all. It was just a really nice treat, because I just came down to visit, and all of a sudden, wow, I get to be on the record, so.
Great. Do you think you'll be performing with them at all, or?
She wouldn't have me on the same stage with her, not for all the tea in China.
Why is that?
Because I pull her hair and do funny things behind her back.
You crazy kid.
There you go. But I get around Eva and I forget myself. I lose all control.
Reinstates you?
I beg your pardon?
She reinstates your youth.
You know, Eva doesn't have to do that.
She makes me aware.
Stefan's got that taken care of.
Guy cornered that market. She makes me aware of my sexuality. You know, you know how I met Evo? I'll tell you how I met Evo. For the last tour that Human Drama did, because I'm relatively new with the band, and I don't know all the faces. Just about every show that we did, there was this big, bright, shining smile looking up and always being there, and always being there. And I thought, well, who the hell's that? And the next thing you know, I am being introduced, but many shows later. And here you go, and she's always there, and it was really nice because that's a whole bunch of support. And that was the nicest part of that.
First time I ever met her.
When did you start working with her on music?
It was actually Eva O called me just before Christmas of 1992, so probably the day before Christmas, and told me she was
making a solo record, and Johnny was producing it, and she wanted to know if I wanted to do the drums on it. I said, yes, I'd love to. And ever since then, we've started pretty much rehearsing and getting it all together, and Johnny came to town, and we started.
So you were working with Johnny before Halo Experience?
I play in a band called The Drum with Johnny. So yeah, I work for him all the time. So.
And what is it like working on this project? How would you say it differs from some of the stuff you do with Johnny and you, the drummer?
There's definitely a camaraderie going on here. Not that we don't have a team drama, but this has been a lot of fun here, Eva, and there's actually a lot of similarities between working with Human Drama, because obviously we're both doing it, but it's different this time to be a little more removed. It's Eva's solo record. It's Eva's record, and we're just trying to kind of help make it better as best we can.
So you're kind of helping with the producing also?
No, and I don't really help too much with that. I throw my two bits here and there, but not too much. I help with the engineering. I've been doing some of that, and all the drums.
You heard the music that's on the up-and-coming album.
The new album?
Yeah.
That was just when I was in the studio. And it had a real, interesting touch with it. It had, the early Pink Floyd keyboards in there. And, an updated sound to go along with it. So I think it's pretty original, too, because no other bands, that put into that quote-unquote gothic genre have thought about doing stuff like that before, because they're all mainly influenced by other 80s bands and, early 70s bands. There's a definite flavor on this new record.
Have you seen Eva perform in the early
80s, late 80s? No, the only time I saw her was called Christ Death, and that was with Roz. They were doing some Germs covers, and that was around 88. Mm-hmm. So that was the first time.
In your opinion, how do you think she's progressed from say the 80s or even the super heroines when you first?
I think that it would be a shame if this record was not performed live as often and as much in as many different cities as possible. I think Eva is a very strong presence. She has a lot of notoriety, and I think that with this record, that notoriety will finally blossom into something that more people will find really special. It's very well structured. Every little piece of music is very, very important to the track. Her vocal is much more dynamic than in the past. What I tried to instill into her vocal performance was that less is more. The only way that the really, really hard and real screaming parts are important is if you do fill it up with other things that are softer and more low-key and more whispery.
Project did she contact you on?
She actually contacted me about three or four months prior to sending me any demos of the record to just speak about the possibilities and to tell me why she was asking me to do the record. She noted to me some of the problems that she had had in recording in the past and that she wanted to experience something new. She had heard a couple of Human Drama albums, which are just loaded with dynamics, and she wanted her record to be more dynamic than the Shadow Project records or the Superheroine records that she had done in the past.
What aspects do you feel?
solo experience has always been a challenge, and I think that it always will be. There's always some kind of push behind me that makes me push myself harder. So what would be your ultimate goal for the Halo experience? Where do you want it to go? Or what do you want to happen for the band?
Oh, I would like to be able to turn on as many people as possible to it, you know? Get everyone around the world to tune in and just listen. If they don't like it, then they don't like it. If they do, that's great. That's why we do it. Just so people can listen. We just put our souls into this music. So.
Goddess.
She doesn't wear underwear when she plays.
And that is her special feature.
I was supposed to do the tour with
all right.
In the beginning.
Oh, next time. That's nice. Yeah.
I wish.
Yeah, so do I. But, yeah, as soon as it gets back, no problem. She's very strong.
I know,
she's
trying to kill
me.
Dave, unfortunately, he's popped down for a pre-show cocktail, so.
Cocktails, where are they?
They're like a mixture of drinks, like liquor and stuff. Oh.
Woo! Where'd you find them?
Marvelous, sunny in California, obviously.
Condo.
Sorry, it's a bit of a same-sex thing. Yeah.
Nice to meet you too.
Yeah, he'll be back. Yeah, Gordon. But do you mind if we do this after the show?
Sure.
It's just that they want to. We've had a lot of long drives on this one.
Oh yeah.
And they want to chill out, have a drink,
sure.
Do the show, and then you can spend as much time as whatever.
Are you the manager?
No, I'm the tour manager.
Exactly.
It's the god of rock and roll.
That was him in a country and western outfit.
Yeah, of course. Incredible.
Viva Oz Halo experience.
Aren't we?
Halos, flaming yeah. Halos.
They're flaming halos everywhere.
That's what everybody.
Did you enjoy the show, Brian?
Yeah, it was a good show.
Did I make a mess?
She plays the best guitar that she's ever played.
Where's he at?
Now, it's probably outside.
I don't have anything to drink.
You want soda? Okay. Yeah, the room.
I'm caught on you.
Paris has a drink.
We should
have these good tickets.
I'm just drinking like soda right now.
I said, well, the heart.
Sure.
In a memory,
I left him in a memory.
I'll be playing two songs right now for you that I've never recorded or I just wrote a few, not too long ago. So they're pretty fresh, and I just thought I'd share it with everybody. One's called, the first one I'm going to play is called I Dream of Love. And the second song is called Look in Your Mirror. And I guess the name is tell you basically what they're about. I hope you like it.
Look in your mirror. I'd like to take this moment to thank you for your support in my music, and I pray that you only receive a positive message from my words. Love is the answer.